Hey everyone, welcome to episode 120. I'm going to do a little bit of an intro for you because we did a podcast sort of off the cuff and it could be confusing. I just got done editing it and I was like, you know what, if I start this off this way, everybody's going to be like, what is going on? So we were at Katie's mom and dad's house and her dad started telling us a story and it got, I don't know, 2 minutes into it and I was like, we have to have this recorded. And I had the equipment in the car, so we went and busted it out and set up in their kitchen. There was, I don't know, maybe 7 kids, a bunch of adults. There was a ton of noise going on, air conditioners. It was just a big party, so, you know, you're going to hear all that stuff. But I felt like there was some parts in it that were I didn't want to go to waste, so I definitely wanted to put the episode out. I hope you guys enjoy it. But here you go, episode 120, Timberlines. Welcome, everybody, to the Bob and Katie Show.
I'm Katie.
And I'm Bob. Introduce them to yours.
And here with us for the very first time are my parents. Mom, Audrey.
Say hello.
Say hi.
Hello.
And my dad, Rocky.
Hello.
And my sister's here, too. She don't have a microphone, though.
Hello.
Carrie's here, too.
Carrie's a big mouth. We can hear her. This was impromptu.
Yes.
Is that how you say that word?
Mm-hmm. Yeah, we had a family gathering today. It's our June celebration. And for anybody who doesn't know, our family has a lot going on in June. Mm-hmm. Starting with June 2nd is my brother's birthday.
Are we going to name them all out?
Real fast. The 2nd's my brother's birthday.
This is happening.
The 10th is his wife's birthday. The 12th is my birthday.
It's still happening.
The 16th is our anniversary. And then there's Father's Day, which is on the 17th this year. So all that within the first, like, 2 weeks of June. So we just have, like, one big June celebration. So we had that today.
Katie always gets mad at me because when we start packing up to go somewhere, I start grabbing recording equipment and put it in the truck. For no other reason than, hey, maybe the opportunity will come up and we need to record something. The reason I pulled it out is because you, Rocky, started telling us a story about a car.
Oh, my goodness.
So I want you to do the best of your ability to tell us that story again because it was amazing.
Yeah, so, Dad,
look here when you're telling it.
Your job, you guys, you go and your boss, he buys cars, and you guys would fix them up, repair them, and then he sells them. So you help him, you know, go pick up the cars, bring them back, help him and everything. So there was one very interesting car you were telling us about.
Oh, the Impala.
Yes.
The Impala, yeah.
Oh, my goodness, the Impala. Oh, it's
I don't even know the car.
Real nice.
So tell us a story, just like you told a while ago.
Oh, no. Oh, just like I told a while ago.
Yeah.
Tell us what you told us a while ago.
So you don't want gory stuff, do you know?
No, you can tell the gory stuff.
No, yeah, I want to know.
Yeah, tell everything.
No, you might not.
All right, it's fine. Yeah. Start with the smell.
You picked up this, what was it, 2013?
Yes.
Impala.
Hey, your child's eating dog food.
Yeah, nice with
the
dog.
Reagan, go get the dog food. Away from
this. 2013 Impala, super nice until you opened the door.
Yes. Oh, my God. It was horrible. Yeah, I fell back. I run back. Shoo-wee, it was horrible.
Then I said, did something die in the car?
I looked for bullet holes everywhere because usually you'll find a bullet hole, but there weren't no bullet holes. So evidently he got stabbed or shot and then crawled back in the car.
And bled out.
In the car.
I mean, there sort of was a dead body in the car.
Yes.
Just not
or dying body.
Currently at the moment.
At the moment, with, right.
So how much blood?
Oh, my.
How much blood was in this car?
Okay, hold on. Let me interrupt. Dad came in one night and had a pair of Ray-Bans. And I'm thinking, oh, cool, you know, name brand.
Oh, got me some more Ray-Bans.
That's what I thought. I got a new Ray-Ban, pair of Ray-Bans. I put them on my face, and Dad's looking at me saying, take those off. Okay, so he said, there's blood on them. I threw them things across the room and went and washed my face and my hands.
Ew. So, like, are we talking about just blood in the passenger seat? What? Now, with that amount of blood, how you clean it? Like, was he just going to clean the blood?
He thought so.
Because I'm thinking.
Yeah, we wiped the car down. It sat in the yard for at least 2 weeks. And every time you opened the door, it kept getting worse. And he cleaned it out again.
The smell? The smell kept getting worse? What kept getting worse?
The smell kept getting worse, yeah.
Because I think if somebody bleeds out, that's a lot of blood.
Yeah, well, see, we didn't realize how bad the extent it was. I know whenever I opened the car door, there was big old clots.
Oh, my God.
Oh, like there was like
Mom,
chunks?
Are you okay? Are you... Mom's like, just like turning green around the gills.
Yeah.
Make that ball disappear. He's not looking at it right now.
So,
that'll work. Oh! Here comes the tears.
No, he's good. We take the seats out of the car. We change the seats. He thought that's going to be enough. I kept thinking, no. For some reason or another, the shifter. We had to take the shifter apart, and I had to take the console out of the car. Oh, my God.
It was inside the console?
Oh, my God. Where the shifter, you know, it was in the console. It went down the end there and underneath the console. Oh, my God.
So did you guys burn the car? Or
like, I'm thinking at this point you cut your losses.
Take it to the junkyard?
No, my boss man ain't going to lose no money.
Oh, my God. So he's going to sell the death car?
No. We stripped the inside of it out. We took front seats, back seats, carpet. The head panel, all this stuff can come out, right? We take all this stuff out. And then, like, the floorboard's got little plastic plugs you can punch out, and there's a hole there. And I take the water hose and wash.
Oh, my. Was there blood down there, too?
Yeah, the boss man, he went through it first, right? He did it.
That's probably a law against this.
Yeah, he was. Yeah.
Were you sure you guys weren't destroying a crime scene?
Well, see, my boss, man. He,
like,
he
hiding the evidence or something?
I hope not.
Oh, but, God.
He gives me a paycheck. I do what he says to do.
Here, so, you know, we don't do nothing unlawful stuff like that. No, we got.
It doesn't sound like it. Not at all. So, tell everybody what you found in the trunk.
Yeah, we opened the trunk, man. It was all kind of goodies. It was like Christmas time. Man, Lord have mercy. There was all kinds of stuff. Golf clubs, man. Lord have mercy. A sweet set, man. Bags and all, man. Had little socks over them all, man. That was nice. Nice set, man. Brand new boots in the box. Timberline boots, man.
You got the Timberlines.
Yes, or the nice ones, the expensive ones. Yeah. That was two boxes of them. Yeah,
what?
Brand new in the box still. All kinds of goody stuff. You name it. Tools, brand new tools, man. Air compressor. Them little air compressors, you know, you get to put in your trunk and car. This one weren't just the air compressor, man. It was everything. It was 5-in-1. It was
everything.
It was a roadside toolkit and everything right in one. I'm talking about this thing was awesome, bro. It was like Christmas time in the back of that car. Oh, all kinds of stuff. He must have had something to do with some kind of stereo stuff because there was mics and stuff like that in there.
Well, now you have my attention.
Oh, man, yeah, that was nice.
What
happened to the microphones?
My buddy, I got work with me, Henry. Mm-hmm. Oh, man, he backed his car. Yeah, he backed
Why Henry get all the good
there.
Stuff?
Well.
So Why Henry get the Timberlines?
Well, they weren't my size. He offered them to me, but they was too small for me.
Oh.
So, you know, I'm generous fellow, so I said, no problem.
But like, since you did clean all the blood out this car, would you like these Timberlines?
Yeah. I was looking at them real hard, but he was talking about he wanted them because he was going to start playing golf. I said, well, if you're going to start playing golf, you know, go ahead and take off.
Is he going to play golf in the Timberlands?
Probably. Yeah. He might have found a pair of jeans up in that thing, too. There was all kinds of things.
So he had a whole golfing outfit.
Yeah.
he had a whole brand new outfit to go play with some golf.
The golf shoes with the metal cleats and all on the bottom of them.
It had golf shoes in it?
Yeah, man. They was in there, too. Yeah, everything up in there.
This poor soul that bled out in his car.
He was just trying to go play some golf.
He bled his heart. He was just trying to go play. Like, I'm sorry for this dude to bled out, but he had some cool stuff up in his car.
He did. My goodness, he set us right.
Guess he won't be needing it anymore.
That's right. I didn't think so anyway. Not all that blood in that car. I don't think so.
So, is there anything else that can top the death car? Have you ever found anything else interesting in a car?
Oh, I'm all the time finding stuff interesting. All kinds of stuff. I'm telling you, you can find it. A lot of them, you can tell whenever there's a woman that's got a bunch of kids. Oh, my.
Well, I have. Do you find lots of Cheerios and French fries?
Almost. Cheerios, French fries, candy stuck everywhere. Lord, how
tell them about your car. The car that Greg gave you, the little...
Oh, well, we won't talk about little Greg.
What was in your car, Dad?
There's a lot to talk about.
Remember that day? He came in here and was like, there's bags and bags of clothes in my car.
What?
He's had the car for months and never looked in these bags of clothes.
So you're just riding around with strangers' clothes?
Well, it ain't my car, really. It belongs to some other gentleman. Actually, I believe it belongs to his mother-in-law, but anyway.
Hold up. You gave me somebody else's clothes.
So you gave Karen your boss's maybe mother-in-law.
You know, we've had the car for like 6 months now.
Like, she probably don't want them anymore.
Hold on now. Now, if this was
still some of them.
Hold on.
Yeah, it was.
If this was his mother-in-law's clothes, I'm kind of wondering about Miss Mother-in-law. Because it was some skimpy stuff in there. And like full bodysuits type things. There was some weird stuff.
Rompers?
There was a leather skirt and a leather like bustier in there.
Oh my.
Some, like,
did you say letter or leather?
Leather.
Okay.
It probably sounded like letter.
You know, to teach the kids their ABCs.
Have you ever noticed, like, it's a thing that I would say 90% of women do. If they start describing what kind of clothes they wear or talking about their breast or anything like that, they always do this. All of them do it.
Mom, Carrie, when you go to look for something, is it like one of the first things you do, go,
yeah.
Where's my keys?
Yes.
Where's my
phone?
There's
women at this table, and they're all patting their breasts.
like you had glasses.
Look at the hand motion. Me and you, we sit here, our hands are still and all. But there, you can't get.
It's like they're
close
Italian.
To them.
Yeah.
I'm very animated with my hands when I talk. Anyway.
Oh yes, I have to.
I guess we got that from our mother.
No, I got a sister, and if you tie her hands, she won't be able to say a word.
Which sister are you referring to?
My middle sister.
She got a name. Y'all call her middle sister.
Yeah.
Yeah, she got a name. She sure does. Any more questions? Does she have hair too?
Yes, she got hair. Yeah. I hate to say her name because some people might mistake her for my wife.
What?
They have the same name. They have the same name.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, but it's not my wife. Reagan, it's my sister.
Go away.
They're, all the children have migrated in here. You want to say hello?
Pow, 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 pow.
Say hello.
Okay.
Well, now you ain't gonna talk.
All right, we'll go away.
Go in there and play.
We'll go away.
This is why we record at 2 o'clock in the morning.
While the children are sleeping.
Oh, gracious. How lovely they are.
Okay, so your sister has the same name as your wife.
Yeah.
We've established that she's the middle child.
Right.
And she has hair.
Yeah.
What other interesting facts can you tell us about
her? She's very animated when she talks.
Yeah, very animated. Yes. She talks with her hands.
Like Japanese anime or just...
Just that old Audrey anime.
My dad's eyebrows.
Oh my gosh.
Mom,
yes.
You've been really quiet. Get up on your microphone.
Yes.
So, you also find interesting things at work sometimes.
Oh gosh.
You have been cleaning houses for a whole lot of years.
Yes.
We won't put in a whole lot of years. And I know...
At least half the years.
I know. People are all the time giving you stuff. Like, you're all the time coming home with stuff that people just... Here, you're the cleaning lady. Would you like these random things?
They're so generous.
I mean, people are always... You've been given furniture.
Yes. Hideaway sofas and lamps and end tables.
Dishes.
Dishes.
Clothes.
Clothes. Everything, money.
Money. Hey,
I like the money.
Money is good.
I like the money.
That's kind of expected.
So what's the weirdest
thing
you've ever got?
What is the weirdest thing that anybody's ever given you? Or that you've just found? Because, I mean, you go up in people's houses. Up in their personal space.
I do. Well, I found some weird things, but a lot of those weird things I don't bring home with me.
That's for the best.
I try to leave those there. Oh.
You have to try? I've really got to try and leave this here this time.
So far it's weird. I don't know. The whole job is weird.
Okay, I remember being with Mom on a job years ago, and it was for a young college girl.
Oh my Lord.
Okay, yeah, okay.
She had a really nice house to be a college girl, but, like, downstairs, she had, like, a movie theater. Like, she had the whole downstairs was, like, and in the corner there was a bar. Well, so I'm sitting there cleaning the bar, and all of a sudden, I stumble upon her smoke.
Her what?
Smoke. Her
smoke?
Her Mary Jane.
Her Mary Jane.
Her Mary Jane.
Oh.
Yes. Drugs. Mom, look at this. Yes.
Okay.
Leave that there.
Did you bring that home?
No. No, of course not.
See, we left that there.
Mom, look.
I swear I'm not insinuating that my mom steals things.
No. I've been in many of houses that we clean for and found that.
It's crazy. I remember me, Mom, and Carrie, we were cleaning a beach house one time for an older couple. And we found airplane bottles stashed all in the lady's bed.
Yes, all under the covers. She was a closet alcoholic.
She was a bed alcoholic because it was stashed all up in her bed in the covers, like little airplane bottles of vodka.
How many airplane bottles?
We did at least
4 or 5.
Oh, okay.
At a time.
That's not horrible. I can drink 4 or 5 airplane bottles.
In your bed?
After you go to bed, yes. Well,
just laying there in bed, drinking some little
Is she married?
Yeah.
Yes.
Yes.
Well, maybe that's why.
Because they sleep in separate beds.
Yeah, they have separate bedrooms and everything.
Oh, it's completely understandable if they sleep in separate bedrooms. I mean, you just want to go to bed, watch some TV, have some drinks. Maybe she was scared she'd spill her cup, so she got little bottles with lids on.
This has a cap.
Yeah, this has got a cap. Y'all stop judging
She might as well just put it in a sippy cup.
You don't know her life.
God bless her.
Oh, oh my goodness! Please, is that the secret to happiness? Because you know, a long time ago, people
separate bedrooms and drink alcohol.
Well, no, people used to have like separate beds.
I think this is how a lot of couples, when they've been married for many years, and when they start to have trouble, instead of separating, they just go to separate beds
and drink themselves into oblivion.
So the children don't know that they're having trouble.
You know, like, I think people were onto something back in the day when they had separate beds. Because I'm just saying, like, we have a king size bed.
Well, if you have a snoring spouse.
Well, Bob don't even snore, but I'm like, you stay on your side and I'll stay on my side. Don't touch me. Don't cross the neutral zone. Don't put your feet over on my side and be cutting me with your toenails. You
leave my toenails out of it.
I will not, because they have hurt me in the past.
I cut Reagan the other day. She come running across me. I mean, I didn't cut her. Like, you know, I was just sitting in the chair and my foot was kind of propped up a little bit. And kids, they want to be on top of you constantly, just like this. Just she's walking in. There's a TV in there and other kids to play with. And she's in here laying in my lap. But she went running across my feet. And she swiped him on the side.
Slice her?
Oh, yeah. Sliced her good.
Oh, my goodness.
It's something about the man toenails. Dad, I know you got them, too. Your toenails.
Oh, yeah.
What is it about man toenails? Why are they so thick?
I've seen some men's toenails look like Fritos. You know what I'm talking about? They're all thick and curly. Mine ain't like that, though. Mine gets sharp.
Your toenails are pretty thick.
Like razor blades. Now, you said one time that somebody gave you lingerie.
Yeah, I've been given all kinds of stuff.
How does that happen? How does that play out?
Well, they'll end up giving me a bag of clothes or something, and it'll be in there, not specifically lingerie itself. Never from a man.
Here's this nightie. I think it would look really good on you, Audrey.
It's
like a white box with a bow on it.
Nothing like that.
A gift.
Try it on in that room over there.
Like, come out here and let me see it when you're done.
Okay, I think the weirdest thing I've ever run into at work, though, was a body in the bed that I wasn't expecting.
Like a dead body?
No, not a dead one.
Oh!
Just a sleeping one.
I was like, oh my God!
I mean, were they the ones that paid you to come?
Their mom. He was like 18, 19 years old. Uh-huh. And we didn't know he was going to be in the house. We had to use the key to get in and all, and I go into the bedroom, and there's a body in there. And so,
did he wake up?
Eventually, but we just didn't clean that room.
That's probably okay. That would have been alarming, I think, at best, if you woke up and there was just, like, strange women in your house cleaning your room.
You're like, well, your mama paid me to be here, so.
So how did you two meet?
Three friends.
You want to elaborate?
That was a very short answer, Mom.
Well, it was.
How old were you? Was it love at first sight?
Well.
See, what happened was.
I had moved out here to this community. I don't know if you want to say the names.
Yeah.
What, Leland?
Leland.
Okay, that's fine.
I didn't know if you want to
say
the names.
You could name a town. It's okay.
I had moved out here to Leland.
And our address was.
And he was friends with some mutual friends of mine, and he came over and left his girlfriend out in the car.
Why you leave your girlfriend in the car?
I'm sorry, I was
because he just met me.
I was distracted by the children.
So you come to visit some friends, and you got your girlfriend with you, not mom, a different girl, and you're just like, hold on, sit right here. I'm going to go in here. You just stay in the car.
He was captivated.
So let me get this right.
See, you need to fix something right here.
You drove over there with your girlfriend in the car, knowing that you were going in to meet another girl?
Well, I weren't, going necessarily...
You could just say yes. It's okay. It's a long time ago.
Yeah. All right. But see, in my defense, it was a boyfriend's house.
It was her boyfriend's house? It was your boyfriend's house?
Mm-hmm.
Were you? Okay.
So,
he was
gone.
So.
Mom!
No, but I wasn't back home. He was gone. And Rocky.
I wasn't doing anything wrong. He wasn't home. It was his fault.
No. Rocky came to see him. That I was there. He came in the house.
Well, obviously, Dad knew that you was there and made his girlfriend sit in the car.
We were sitting there talking, and something come up about a girlfriend. Uh-huh. And he says, she's in the car. I was like, well, tell her to come in. And he goes, no. So I'm like, well, all right then.
And so how soon after did you break up with your boyfriend and did you break up with your girlfriend?
Oh, it was a while.
Okay.
That was just a mutual meet.
So, I'm just going to ask a question. Did either one of you cheat on the ones you were with each other?
No. No. We didn't.
Oh, that would have been great.
No,
like,
we
radio
didn't.
Jeez Louise.
I broke up with him.
My parents have morals.
And it was afterwards when me and you started seeing each other.
Did you hear our voice change?
Her, matter of fact, I left her house.
Were you living with her?
Huh?
Were you living with her? You said you left your girlfriend's house to go to her house.
Uh-huh.
Were you living with your girlfriend?
Eventually.
Riley O'Neal!
Not necessarily.
I have my own place. He just comes see me sometimes.
Okay.
So how old were you guys when this was going down?
12.
I was 19.
19.
Y'all the same age?
He was almost 19.
Dad is 9 months younger than mom?
Yeah.
Right. Yeah, I catch up her 4 months out of you.
That's all right. Is that you? What is that?
What?
That's him.
Oh, I'm sorry.
I was like, what is that noise?
Nervous too.
I thought it was the kid. So, y'all met when you were 19.
The second time.
And so, how long were you guys dating before you got married?
Let's see. I was 21, so...
So, you guys moved pretty quick.
Yeah. Well, we had moved in together for a year. And, well, almost two. And then...
You know, Jesus doesn't appreciate that.
That's what our parents started saying. You have to get married. You're living in sin. So we did.
Let's make it legal.
Is that why you guys got married? Because you were like tired of grandma going, "You're living in sin, Audrey."
Well, kind of, sort of. I mean, we lived together for a year, you know, and we were going along just fine, but okay. You know, but yeah, we loved each other, so we're like, well, okay, we'll do this thing.
Oh,
you know,
well, that's nice.
Wanted to do it on Valentine's Day, but couldn't get a florist to do the wedding that day, so we got married the day after.
So February 19th?
15th.
Oh my gosh. But, I know we've talked about it on another episode, you guys just got remarried and you got remarried.
Yeah. On Valentine's Day.
Oh, so that you got it corrected.
Mm-hmm, that's right. So we got our way anyway.
That's right.
So you guys have been together for how long?
Since February.
Since February of this year.
This time.
The rest of it doesn't count. It doesn't matter.
So
you guys actually already had kids coming into the marriage.
Yes.
That's all right.
And grandkids.
So when y'all got married, you had 7 grandkids.
Yeah.
That's not how you should kick off a marriage. That sounds like a lot of stress.
And to be able to have them in the wedding, too, that's special. That is special.
Oh. That's something.
Yes, it was.
They're rotten. They're like scrambling all around our feet right now.
Yeah. All right, so you got 3 kids. Now, which one's your favorite?
Don't play favorites.
Look,
that's my
we
favorite.
All don't know.
That's right.
Here's the deal.
Child, and I got a favorite young one down the road.
They all my favorites.
Here's the deal. Katie and I have been parents for almost 4 years now.
Uh-huh.
And y'all lying.
No.
Everybody.
I'm not lying.
No.
I love them all unconditionally. I love them all. But I might have a favorite.
No, see, I think every parent who has more than one child, you love all your children the same.
Yes.
But at different times.
Yeah.
You might like one a little more than the others.
Oh.
Well, what happened was. Yes, since my baby just turned 30, I can say this. So through the process of growing children. And in the different phases that each of you go through, sometimes you tend to be a little closer to one at a particular time.
Quit sugarcoating.
And then on down the line.
Sometimes, some days you'd be like, I don't even like this one.
Well, some days you don't like me either.
Oh, yeah. It goes both ways. My kids tell me quick they don't like me.
Patreon.com/TheBobAndKatieShow. If you enjoy listening to the show and you want to help support it, please go to Patreon.com. You can pledge anywhere from $1 to $1 million. Actually, more than $1 million, technically, if you want to get real with it. But I don't think you should spend $1 million.
Yeah, I don't even know. Is there a cap?
There might
be. Is there a limit?
I
don't know.
Let's find out. I need somebody to go on there right now and see how
challenge accepted.
It will let you do. We have 17 episodes now on the Patreon page, including the last one where I actually got her name wrong while we were talking about it. It was Ali Wong.
I kept calling her Amy Wong, and you never corrected me.
I don't.
So
did you? I don't remember.
I think so. I might have.
But, I don't think you did.
All kidding aside, go to patreon.com/thebobandkatieshow and help support your local podcasters. Also, if you want to show your support, and
buy
you're
a shirt.
In, yeah, buy a shirt. Oh, we're selling shirts right now.
Yes.
Yes, for only
25
across the board, no matter what size. Shipped anywhere except overseas. If you want to buy a shirt and you live overseas, go ahead and be prepared to spend like $55. It is outrageous. I didn't realize when we first did this how insane it was to try to ship a shirt on a level as small as we are. I think if you're like a big corporation, there's probably some kind of thing you can do.
We're happy to do it. We're happy to ship, but we do have to charge more just to cover our expense. That's all.
Yes. I mean, like, so I'm not going to feel bad if nobody orders from overseas because I love Tell 'em Steve Dave, and if I had to pay $55 for a shirt, it's not happening.
I mean, if anyone overseas wants to order a shirt, they can always give us their address, and we can check on the shipping costs and just, you know, let you know how much it would cost us.
Yes. And we don't have these sitting around, so what we're doing is the same thing we did last time. We're going to take all the orders for the next 2 or 3 weeks.
Yeah, very limited time. If
when
you
we
want
finish,
a shirt.
Yeah, when we finish, we'll order them and then send them out.
And if Mom!
What happened?
No, you are not!
What did she say?
Mom said, I'm going to step out here and smoke a cigarette.
I thought you were three.
No, we were waiting for Dad to come back.
No. We're just doing commercials. This is it. You got to pay the bills.
Oh, I did commercials.
Oh, you shouldn't listen to the show at all. What else is happening? July 13th, if you are in the Charlotte area, the Bob and Katie Show will be out and about. We're going to go see Fitness, the band Fitness. We're going to hang out with them, record a podcast. Don't look at me like you don't know what I'm talking about. We've talked about this before. It's happening. I've got babysitters lined up already. It's moving. If you guys haven't heard of Fitness before, we featured one of their songs a while back. But how you probably know the guys is they were in a band called Eve Six. If you don't know who they are, I am positive that 90% of you have heard the song Eve Six, not Fitness. But I mean, it's the same singer.
The heart in the blender.
I'll play a little clip of it real quick. These guys right here, like, I think this song was like top one for quite a while.
Late,
is this one of those
like
one
late
of those songs?
90s? Yeah. That song came out whenever I was in high school, I believe.
So, come out. I don't know the name of the venue because I wasn't prepared, but we'll put more information out about that. But it's July 13th. Come hang out, see a cool show. We'll be there during the show. We'll talk to people. We're not going to record the episode in public. We'll probably do that at a hotel room or backstage or something like that. But it's going to be a good time. So come hang out and hear some music. What are we talking about now?
My parents, when they met, got married.
So you two have never been on a podcast before.
No.
It's very simply this. Have you ever sat outside by the fire and like just talked? That's all it is. Both of you, I guarantee, have one of those stories that you...
Dad!
That, like, whenever you have that opportunity, you're like, oh, I've got a story for you.
Oh,
so,
Dad.
What is that story? I want to know that story.
I think Dad has a story in mind, the way he was laughing. Tell us a story,
Yeah,
Dad.
Tell us a story.
Tell us a story.
I'm not saying that you're old, but you have some years on you. And my favorite part about talking with people that have some years on them is... I've never had to experience a lot of stuff that, like, you had to experience growing up. Like I had Nintendo when I was a kid. You know what I mean? Like, there was air conditioning and bathrooms inside and stuff like that.
We had sticks.
We had woods and holes we dug in the yard and put fire in them, set around, get Dad to go get some, sometimes it might be screwdriver.
When you were a child?
When you were a kid?
But, well, no, we was like 15, 16 years old. But Wyoming was our favorite one back then. We used to like that, what they call Boone's Farm.
I know what Boone's Farm
is.
Almost
Jay Swan.
Every teenager knows about Boone's Farm.
Oh, Boone's Farm.
Like, so many people right now just have that memory of that time you puked Boone's Farm.
Aren't they the ones that have that, like, that blue Hawaiian...
Yeah, yeah. It's so blue.
Oh,
yeah. Right? You just had that memory right now. I saw it on your face. You're like, I remember that time that I puked it up. You were a part of that
memory. I don't know that we weren't sitting at a table just like this glass one. So this is when we lived with Matt and Ashley. We had a bunch of people over one night. We were partying. And we were all sitting at a table. And they were like, oh, we're going to play this game. Where, like, one person starts drinking. Like, they'll start drinking their beer. And then as soon as they start, you have to start. And you can't stop until the person beside you stops. So then, like...
That sounds like who's going to puke first.
Right, right. Well, I didn't have a beer, and I was sitting at the table, so I ran to the freezer, and I grabbed a bottle of that blue Hawaiian Boone's Farm stuff. So I sat down, and I just started chugging it, and I drank that entire bottle of wine in one go. And it turns out that when you puke it up, it's the same color, except it has little things floating in it. Disgusting. That's my Boone's Farm story.
My stomach's a little queasy right
now.
So
I want your story. Like, what is that one story that, like, you have a couple drinks in you, there's a fire going, you're like, oh, let me tell you this story that happened to me when I was a kid or when I was a teenager or whatever.
Don't mix.
What?
Don't mix it.
Don't mix what? Like, what are you talking about?
I put
Boone's Farm and TJ Swan, and then maybe go add some MD 2022.
Oh my gosh.
Like a Irish Rose, you know, that stuff like that.
Oh my
It's cheap, you know, whenever you're a teenager and stuff, you got a whole bunch of money. So you go for cheap stuff, right? Oh my God.
Makes me feel like a loser. I didn't buy alcohol when I was a teenager. I guess I did.
No.
See,
no.
I was like 19.
He was a wild country boy.
You see what you did? You go setting fruit. It used to be a fruit stand, is what we called it, right? But they didn't have just fruit, they had a little bit of everything, right? And what you do, you catch the older gentlemen, right? Whenever they was going in to get their stuff, and you say, hey man, here you go. Here's an extra five, you know, get me such and such while you're in there, right? Uh-huh. And then they bring your stuff back out to the car to you, right? For a little tip. And so, we used to go sit out by the fruit stand and catch them old. You'd have to catch the right one, you know. Everybody wanted to do it for you.
This is why they have laws now.
But no, there was this one fella, my buddy, we was going off, and he went and picked his girlfriend up. His girlfriend had a cousin down the street, and then his cousin, his brother. And so there wound up being five of us, in the car, right?
Uh-huh.
And we go to the fruit stand. Everybody gets something different, right?
Fruit stand with quotations or a legit fruit stand?
No, the fruit stand he was just telling you about that has a little bit of everything.
Yeah. It's a legit stain.
Okay.
Uh-huh. We ain't gonna call no names. But anyway.
Is it still there?
Not at the same location. No,
okay.
Got a new location now, of course. Things are growing the way they are, you know, it's expansion and all.
Mm-hmm.
But yeah, so we always used to go like ride around in the woods and stuff, you know. Call them hunting woods. Had all kinds of roads in the hunting woods, right? Go ride around through the hunting woods, drinking wine.
Oh my God!
No, don't mix it. Hey, if you're gonna drink something, stick to that one thing. Don't go mixing stuff, because mixing stuff, you ask for trouble.
So there was five of y'all. Everybody has something different, and you were just like sharing it around.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Okay. So all right.
Yeah, that's a recipe the top for vomit.
One bottle, and then everybody shared, and then you pop the top on the.
So, all the times that you guys did this, it was always the same story. We drank, we went home, nothing crazy ever happened, nobody ever fell out the truck and hit a tree.
We ain't even got started to crazy stuff yet. No, there was always something crazy. Yeah, all the time. Rolling in the ditch, maybe with your buddy's girlfriend. You know.
Running from the law.
No.
You had to run from the law?
Not that night. Was too busy puking.
Tell me about the law. I want to know about the law. What happened to the law?
We don't go there.
Are they still looking for you?
No. That's a long time ago.
I'm like 35 years old. We like find out my dad's name ain't even Rocky. He's in the window for not witness protection. He's hiding.
You don't know. When Rocky was a young man, he was quite the wild man.
Wait, what? When Rocky was what?
A young man.
Oh, I thought you said in the man. I was like, I don't know what that means.
No, when he was a young man, he was a wild man. There wasn't many people out here in Leland, so it was like Duke's Panzer, you know. Yeah.
No, he's not telling me anything. So you tell me something.
Dad's like hitting that stuff. He doesn't want to incriminate himself. He's like trying to remain innocent.
We got to finish the episode strong. You got to give me something juicy. Tell me something.
I say, do you want to know about the day that the 16 SBI agent showed up at the house?
Yes, that is what I was actually just thinking about that. I was like, I'm sure there has to be a story where 16 SBI agents. I don't even know what SBI is. What is that?
State police.
Okay.
Like the FBI is federal.
I have never been involved with anything that 16 of any kind of government people would show up at the house.
Well, see, that's where I was at that day.
Okay.
We had not gotten married yet. And Rocky had worked for a guy who owed him a lot of money. And he got so far behind, he turned a truck over to us. He put it in my name. And
so he owed Dad a lot of money for working for him. So he's like, I don't have the money to pay you, but here's a vehicle.
Yeah. And we were getting ready to get married.
But he put it in your name.
Yes, because I was holding insurance. And so to put it on my insurance, they put it in my name.
Oh, okay, okay.
Yeah.
I was like, why would he put it in your name? He didn't owe you money.
Huge truck with huge tires. So I'm at work one day at the insurance office, and I get a call from my landlady saying, Audrey, there are 16 SBI agents at your house. And I'm like, could you tell me why? She says, they're looking at your truck. I says, can you tell me why? She says, no, but they want you to come home.
They want to talk to you.
I'm not
going to
do that.
Okay, yeah, I hung up and I said, I will go find Rocky. And
Rocky said, oh no.
And come to find out, we got kind of caught up in a situation where a stolen truck was put in my name.
Oh.
Yes.
Oh, my God.
Yes.
How have I never heard this story before?
They came to my work. They stripped his Mustang to see if it was stolen. It came straight from the Ford company and, you know, proof and everything. And so it was really crazy.
Dad, how do you get mixed up in all these weird vehicle situations?
Well, he came out of it okay, you know.
Did you go to jail that day?
He did.
No, wait, not that day.
We got conflicting stories here.
He did go to jail.
For the truck?
Yes. Because it was stolen. And so we got that all taken care of, got a lawyer, and he came out of it okay. We didn't know that it was stolen.
Okay.
You know.
So you don't have Grand Theft Auto on your record?
No, I didn't know it was stolen at the time.
Oh. We were young and got caught up in something, you know.
So did you ever get your money back?
No.
And they took the truck?
Man, we stay in Leland. This is Leland.
Leland. No, I ain't get my money. That man still owes me.
Is he alive?
I believe so.
You know his address? We walk over there.
No, no. We'll walk all that. He's pretty old now.
I know. That'll make it easy. I'll beat him, old man. How much money is it?
What if we just showed up at this old man's house and be like, excuse me, Mr. So-and-so, I believe you owe my dad X amount of money from... 30.
Hey, but Bob, that was only the beginning of the adventures with Rocky.
Okay.
I have known Rocky since I was 18 years old.
So this was before y'all got married.
Yeah, so this has been over 40-some years of adventures.
So it never raised any red flags for you?
Let me tell you, if John would have did something like that, she would have been like, I think you need to leave me now.
Yeah, Bob, I think if you had gone to jail for getting a stolen vehicle, my mama would have been like, Kay, are you sure you want to do this?
I went to jail one night for a vehicle situation.
You did? My parents drove me down there because I was freaking out.
Yeah.
I was with you in the car and we got pulled over. And the cops took you away.
Yeah.
And I called my mom. I was like, what do I do? They took mom to jail.
Did we ever tell this story?
Yeah.
Did we?
I believe so, yeah.
Okay, yeah. So, long story short, I got a speeding ticket, and I missed the court date. I didn't know I missed the court date. And then
something like that.
My license got revoked at some point, but, I mean, I had to drive for work. So, I mean, do what
we
you got to do.
We didn't know, right?
No, I think we knew that time. There was another time we didn't know. Or no, we knew. No, we didn't know. And then later on, I knew. Yeah,
that was before we got married, too.
Right. And the cop pulled me over.
Right before we got married. I think that was like a month or so before we got married.
Yeah, the cop pulled me over and said, your license has been revoked. And he asked me to get out of the car.
And you're coming with me.
No, he didn't. He said, normally we would take somebody to jail for this. And I go, oh, what are we going to do this time? And he goes, well, you're going to jail. Well, then why would you say normally? If like, why wouldn't you just say, put your hands behind your back? And all right, so I grew up a fat kid. And as a fat kid, you always find that thing that like makes you feel better or like takes the attention off of the fat kiddiness. So with me, it was jokes. The fat kiddiness. I would always make jokes. Like I would constantly try to make jokes just to get away from it. And apparently, when you're in custody, you shouldn't do that. Because I made a joke while I was locked up about drugs. And at which point they put me in a different room. And another cop came up and I had to squat and cough.
Oh, no.
To make sure I didn't have any drugs in me. And
squat and cough. Memorable experience.
He,
I'm pretty sure if I squat and cough right now, I'd pee myself.
Pretty rough. The cop asked me to lift my testicles, and I said, I'm not going to do that. And he said, well, you have to do it, or I'm going to do it. And I said, well, I guess I could do it. And then he told me, he's like, I want you to squat and cough. And I said, well, what if something comes out?
That's what we're looking at.
He said, that's the point. I said, well, I don't have any drugs in me, so if something comes out, we're all going to be uncomfortable. That was actually not the first time I'd made a joke to police officers about drugs, and neither time it turned out good.
Yeah, you probably shouldn't do that.
So, but I got a lot of speeding tickets when I was younger, and I've moved on from that. So
yeah, you best not be bringing home no speeding tickets
all
now.
Those guys have.
Ain't nobody got time for that mess now.
Them things are expensive nowadays. John got one a few weeks ago, taking me to work on the weekend. You know, I have to go do that job on the weekend. And
that job.
The M&M job. The electrician office.
Your family's shady.
I gotta do that job.
You know that job.
You know, well, that
at the
job.
Electrician's office.
We do what we have to do. So, on the way there, he gets a ticket for 72 and a 55.
Okay.
That ticket costs us $300.
Oh, my gosh.
That's not right. Yeah.
And 4 years on the insurance.
Yes, and he hasn't had a ticket in like 20 years.
Now, you were married a while back, and I'm assuming he used to get speeding tickets or something because...
Yeah. At least once a month.
Because you guys had a lawyer, and I picked up that lawyer, and he was the one that always took care of my stuff. Was his name Wright?
No, Owens.
Mm. Owens, that's Fred Owens. Owens. Yes. Yeah. Fred Owens. You know, this is going to be a free advertisement. If he's still in business and you get a ticket in Wilmington... I would give that. I'd go up there. I get that man $250 and just be like, "Thanks." And I never have to go to court or nothing. I get a letter in the mail.
Well, I think everybody.
A phone call.
You've used Fred Owens, Rocky. Has
yeah,
Rocky
Fred,
used
Owens,
Fred Owens.
What's up, man?
Well, yes, Carrie fired him.
Yeah. Oh, he started getting drunk. So.
He started getting drunk.
Yeah, he'd come to court drunk.
What?
The last time I went to court with him, he came to court and he was roasted. And
like first thing in the morning
yes
court.
First thing in the morning court probably hadn't been to bed all night kind of thing he was roasted.
When we lived here with you, I got up one day and I was in that bedroom and I think I had Netflix or something like that, and I watched
Anne Frank.
Yes, that's what it was. I watched The Diary of Anne Frank.
You can't start your morning off that way.
It was like 8 o'clock in the morning. So this movie goes off, and I'm sitting here like, well, this sucks. And I had to go the rest of the day just like starting my day off with like the little girl that died in the attic. Yeah. Well, she didn't die in the attic. Spoiler alert.
the Nazis got her. Did you know, fun fact, that Anne Frank and I have the same birthday. Not the same year, obviously, but her birthday is
You look good for your age.
We have, yes, I share a birthday with Anne Frank.
Okay. Did you know they just uncovered new pages from her diary?
Yeah, I heard about that.
Really?
Yeah. Apparently they were like, they were glued together. She like hid them inside of each other, and they've come up with this new piece of equipment that they can like peer through it to like read it and like, you know, reverse it and stuff, because they don't want to go in there like tearing it apart.
Yeah.
So yeah, I haven't read it. I just know that it happened. I heard it on another podcast. So the more you know. I guess we need to call it. You guys have anything else you want to talk about? No? Well, thank you for being here.
Any other stories that you think we need to hear? I feel like I've learned stuff.
Yeah. Like how not to podcast when there's 11 kids running around.
There's not 11.
Riley, come here, buddy. I need your help.
Go to daddy.
Thank you guys for being here at your house.
Thank you for having us.
We're going to have to do this again, and because I feel like we've just scratched the surface.
Oh, you have.
What, Dad?
Can you help me end the show?
And we need to hear more about Dad's wild days. I mean, heck, he's still having wild days. In the death car.
He's a good guy, though. He's a good guy.
Hey, can you help me end the show? Yeah? All right, say, find your laugh. Get that out of your mouth.
Get your cup out your mouth.
Say, find your laugh. Come on, do it. You can do it.
You can do it.
Say, find your laugh. He's not going to do it. All right. Once again, thanks. I appreciate it.
Thank you.
Find your laugh.
Find your happy.
This has been a CabCast Studios production. For more episodes and information, visit CabCastStudios.com.